In the news this week, the government's Sunday trading plans are challenged by a new legal opinion, proposals to regulate church youth activities in Wales are revealed, and the Queen writes about God's faithfulness ahead of her 90th birthday. Hello and welcome to this week's news bulletin from the Christian Institute. A new legal opinion commissioned by the Christian Institute has highlighted serious problems with the government's plans to liberalise Sunday trading. The government wants to use the Enterprise Bill to devolve the issue of Sunday trading to local areas. It has also proposed changes to the rights of employees, but John Bowers QC has warned that these are inordinately complex. His legal opinion highlights that there is nothing to prevent employers from turning down a job applicant just because they will not work on the Sabbath. Humphrey Dobson, Deputy Director of the Christian Institute, spoke out against the plans.
Well, John Bowers has exposed that the so-called protections being offered by the government are flimsy and very ineffective and will do nothing really to prevent people being pressured to work on Sundays when they don't want to do so. Many more Christians will be forced to choose between their faith and their job. Really here, the government's trying to ignore widespread public opposition. It's not publishing detailed analysis of the 7,000 people who responded to its consultation, so we don't really know how many of those oppose the government's plans. And it's not just Christian groups and churches, small businesses, unions, and people who just want to spend time with their family on a Sunday are opposed to the government's plans, and we really hope that MPs will reject them when they have the opportunity to do so.
MPs will have a chance to oppose the plans at report stage early next month. The Welsh Government has launched a consultation on plans to regulate out-of-school settings, which are strikingly similar to those being proposed in England. The consultation for Wales says that out-of-school settings which educate children for 6 or more hours in any week should be inspected. This could include drama groups, music classes, and church youth activities, but it is not currently clear who would enforce such a regime in Wales. The consultation document states that mutual respect and tolerance of those with different faiths and beliefs is of paramount importance. It also says that people who work in positions of trust and influence must not promote intolerance when expressing their own beliefs. In England, the government has consulted on giving Ofsted legal power to investigate any setting that provides instruction to children for 6 to 8 hours a week or more. The Christian Institute has warned that Sunday schools, holy Bible clubs, and church youth work could be caught by the plans. The Welsh consultation will close on the 5th of April. University pro-life societies should be banned because they seek to oppress half of all people on campus, a student newspaper editor has claimed. Ricky Loftus, the Belfast editor of The Tab, said student unions have a moral obligation to ban pro-life groups. While universities should not be a place of stifled speech, she said, pro-life societies should be prohibited. However, the Alliance of Pro-Life Students told the Christian Institute that pro-life societies help to promote free speech on campus.
Pro-life societies in universities are really important for several reasons. Firstly, it's really important that students have the right to free speech and they can put forward their view on any issue, but on particularly the pro-life issue, respectfully. Pro-life societies also play a really vital role in providing information to their fellow students. So if a student is in a crisis pregnancy or maybe has had an abortion and wants help afterwards, they often will not know where to go for the kind of help that is available. But pro-life students can bridge that gap in providing the information about organisations which can help them.
Staying with abortion, the British Pregnancy Advisory Service has launched a campaign to change the law and allow abortion up to birth for any reason. The campaign wants abortion to be completely decriminalised and calls for the removal of two sections of the 1861 Offences Against the Person Act. Speaking after the launch of the campaign, the executive officer of pro-life group Right to Life, Peter Williams, said the abortion lobby is out of touch with science, medicine and public opinion. The idea that abortion is just another medical procedure and that it should be a free-for-all action outside of public ethical concerns is ludicrous. The legal limit for abortion in Great Britain is 24 weeks. But if the child is disabled, abortion is allowed up to birth. And finally, the Queen has spoken about God's steadfast love in a new book to celebrate her 90th birthday. The comments come in a book entitled The Servant Queen and the King She Serves. I have been and remain very grateful to you for your prayers and to God for his steadfast love. I have indeed seen his faithfulness. It has been published by the London Institute for Contemporary Christianity, Hope and the Bible Society, and a 12-page version for schools is being made available by Scripture Union. Well, that's all for this week. For regular updates and more information on all of our stories, plus much more, visit our website at christian.org.uk. Until next time, goodbye.